This hour is yours. The Standard Hour, radio's oldest hour of fine music, presented each week throughout the year for your enjoyment by the Standard Oil Company of California. This evening, from the Shrine Auditorium in Los Angeles, we present the seventh in our annual fall series of programs devoted to the music of grand opera. And again, we deem it a privilege to bring you, as our conductor, the General Director of the San Francisco Opera Association, Gaetano Merola. As guest soloists this evening, we have two of grand opera's most brilliant stars, mezzo-soprano Blanche Thebom and baritone Robert WEEDE. To open our program this evening, Maestro Merola has selected Semiramide, the Semiramide Overture by Rossini. Gaetano Merula and the San Francisco Opera Orchestra have opened the seventh program in our current Standard Hour Grand Opera series with the Semiramide Overture by Rossini. In his opera, Otello, Giuseppe Verdi successfully achieved what few have attempted. He measured his skill with that of Shakespeare himself. The dramatic power of this tragic tale finds added force in its musical expression. In the second act of the opera, Iago gives voice to the creed by which he lives, a grim confession of faith with a remarkable musical portrayal of its heartless cynicism. To bring it to us this evening, we have pleasure in presenting one of the great singers of our day, baritone Robert Weede. Now with Gaetano Merula and the San Francisco Opera Orchestra, Robert Weede in Iago's Creed from Otello.
Anne, la tua meta già vedo, ti spinge il tuo demone, nel tuo demon sonnio, e me trascina il mio, nel quale ho credo un essere atto di te.
mortal nulla. E vecchia sola il ciel.
You have heard Robert Weedy in Iago's Creed from Otello by Verdi. This day, The Marriage of Figaro remains one of the greatest masterpieces of comedy and music. Its sparkling Mozartian score is alive with melodies at once gay and appealing. Act Two offers us one of the most familiar of these, Cherubino's aria, Voi che sapete. What is this feeling? For our performance tonight, we are honored to present an artist whose name has become a household word wherever opera is known. Mezzo-soprano Blanche Thebom. Here is Blanche Thebom in Cherubino's aria from Mozart's The Marriage of Figaro. Voi che sapete. Blanche Thebom has sung Voi che sapete from The Marriage of Figaro by Mozart. One of the most impassioned and dramatic moments contained in Camille Saint-Saëns' score for Samson and Delilah is brought to us now. Blanche Thebom and Robert Weedy join to bring us the great duet from Act Two of the opera. ¶¶
j'ai gravi la montagne pour venir jusqu'à toi. D'accord, qui m'accompagne, m'a guidé vers ton toit.
Il faut que vous m'enchaîne, je veux
Music just heard was the duet from Act Two of Saint-Saëns opera, Samson and Delilah. The WEEDE and Miss THEBOM are returning to the enthusiastic applause of our audience here in the Shrine Auditorium. Well, this brings us to the midway point in our program. The Standard Hour will continue in just a few seconds, following a brief pause for station identification. You are listening to the 1334th weekly program of fine music brought to you by the Standard Oil Company of California. Tonight, the Standard Hour presents the seventh concert in our annual series of programs devoted to the music of grand opera. The San Francisco Opera Orchestra is under the direction of Gaetano Merula, and our guest artists are Robert WEEDE and Blanche THEBOM. Before continuing the musical portion of our program, here is Mr. Hale Sparks with an urgent reminder for you.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Day after tomorrow is the big day. By this time Tuesday evening, the polls will be closed, the decision will have been made. The United States of America will have elected a new president. Will you be one of the good citizens who can sit back and feel that you've done your part in selecting him? You will, if you vote. This election campaign has been the top news event in the land ever since the conventions. Every newspaper, every radio and television station has given it the widest possible coverage. The candidates have stated their views. The issues have been threshed out in detail. Tonight, most people have made up their minds. You probably know which candidate you favor. So let's see to it that this time, the voting turnout is different from the last presidential election. In 1948, only about half of the qualified voters went to the polls. Whatever the reason, indifference, laziness, or just too busy, they failed to use that great privilege and responsibility, the vote. I don't want that failure on my conscience, and I'm sure you don't want it on yours. When the final tally is made Tuesday night, you want to have your vote counted with those of everyone else who really cares about the future of our country. So, I'll see you at the polls.
Returning to the musical portion of our program, we come to the score of one of the less frequently performed works of Puccini. From his one-act opera, Suor Angelica, Gaetano Merula and the San Francisco Opera Orchestra bring us the intermezzo. Music just heard was the intermezzo from Suor Angelica by Puccini. Familiarly known as Tempest of the Heart is the great aria for baritone Il Ballon del Sorriso, which occurs in the second act of Verdi's Il Trovatore. Robert Weedy sings it for us now.
Deserto, né per l'aurea ancora suona l'usato carme, in tempo io giungo. Ardito e qual purente amore ed irritato orgoglio chiesero a me. Spento il rival, caduto ogni ostacol sembrava ai miei desiri. Novello e più possente l'anne appresta l'altare. Ma no, non sia d'altri Leonora.
Weedy has been heard in Il Ballon del Sorriso from Il Trovatore by Verdi. Once again, the score of the immortal Verdi's Il Trovatore is the source of our music. From the second act of the opera, we are to hear Azucena's song of the vision that rushes through her memory as she watches the blaze of the gypsy campfire, Strida la Vampa. Here is Blanche Thebom to sing it for us.
Strida!
Blanche THEBOM has sung Strilla Vampa from Il Trovatore by Verdi. In the third act of Giordano's Andrea Chenier, Gerard hesitates for a moment before satisfying his passion for the lovely Madeleine by sacrificing his friend, Chenier. The struggle of honor and desire is tellingly expressed in the music which follows. Nemico della Patria. Here is Robert Weedy to bring us this dramatic moment.
Della patria e vecchia schiava e beatamente ancor la beve il posto nato a Costantinopoli straniero giurio a Saint-Cyr soldato tradito ed un morire un complice e poeta sovvertitor di cuori e di costumi.
Lacrime dei vinti e sofferenze.